and Bodie Miller.
Come on, Bud, get this thing!
That familiar, almost laconic look out of the start house, and then that sudden explosion puts him on the course. He's won the last two times here. Can he make it three in a row? Steve, based on the training runs and what else we know about him, your thoughts?
He has not shown in the training runs as he has in the past leading into the two victories. So it's a question. The ankle, also a question. We saw him favorite in the slalom. Talked to his coach today, Forrest Carey. He said the ankle's a problem. We just don't talk about it.
And that ankle, that injury occurred at Beaver Creek back in the second downhill of the season. He crashed there and not only hurt his ankle, I mean, he really battered his body with that very horrific fall. And we're glad to see him stand up and ski down, but the ankle has bothered him all season long, and as you said, he never talks about injuries or makes any excuse of them, so we don't know the exact severity.
And one of the things you will look for is the skiers call it linking the turn, so that one turn bleeds right into the next.
Right,
there's
on
no
those
hitch
gates
in between. And Miller, if to our eye, again, we haven't seen this, taking out some panels, and the skis are running here. You can see linking it up.
Exactly where he wants to be. This line looks great for him. He knows it so well, and he's had success with it. Can he be fast enough? There's DeFago's leading time, and he is behind by 0.2. 25 hundredths behind. He's got to make it up on the bottom now.
And so again, this is where Miller has usually beaten the rest of the world. Now in a position where he has to find time, and the question of the ankle and the fitness now.
Here he comes now down to these final turns of the finish line. Bodie Miller just inside that gate here, the turns that have given the other guys problems right here. He goes well through there. One to go. He clipped the gate. He's wide there to the finish line. And Bodie Miller into second place, 0.2 behind Didier DeFago. 0.2 the difference.